Hello and welcome to this series where I show and explain how a violin is built. In today's video we are going to make the F holes in the top. To make the F holes you need to draw them on some way on the top, and for that you need a model or a pattern. And fortunately, if you order this form from Grand Illutai, you can find inside the box also a model of the F holes which belong to the instrument you are making, in this case the Stradivari Cremonese. You can't see it, but this is what it looks like. It's not so easy to show anyway. And of course you need to know where to put them on the top, something like that, but it's not something like, it has to be exactly on a certain position, as the F holes also indicate the position of the bridge. And there are measurements. Unfortunately, they don't put the measurements into the box, so you have to figure them out in some way. I have the measurements because I have made this instrument also in the past. Let me take them. Here we are. You need the measurements, and you also need to know what you have to measure. And it's almost, you cannot see, that's it. So there are three things that you need to know: the distance from the side until the middle of the F holes, and then the distance between the two F holes on two different points. In every instrument these measurements may differ. I am doing the Stradivari, but if you are working on a Montagnana or a Amati or a Guarneri, for instance, these measurements will be different. The first thing that you have to do is draw a line over the middle of the top. Then you have to measure the distance that you want to put the F holes from the upper edge. And now draw a line over these two points. This line will indicate these points of the F hole. Now you have to draw two lines in this direction to indicate the distance at the upper side of the F holes. And now you have to do the same at the lower part. And now you are ready to put your model over your lines. And this is how it should look when you are ready. Now that I finished drawing the F holes, I want to cut them, but before I have to drill two holes where the saw is going to pass. And for that I'm going to use my drill, and a very thin drill, 2 mm is enough. This is also done, now I can start cutting. But there is a very special way to cut the F holes, in means of which direction you have to go, Because if you do it the wrong way, you might break the top, and that's not what you want, of course. I will show you how to do that. You have to come a bit closer. Of course, you start here at the hole, and you cut first this side, then you go back and cut this corner. And when you arrive here, you have to change side again and go and cut this side. All the way until here. And when you are here, you change side again and cut this side and the corner. And finally, for the last time, you change side again and you cut the last part until here. And don't bother with these two corners, these are for later. To cut the F holes, you need a dovetail, like this one. And you need, of course, a saw. These blades break very easily, so try to have some extra, so you can change them if they break. Now that the holes are cut, we can finish them, so arrive close to the line has to disappear actually. For that you can use knives, a knife like that, which I have used also in the past for the purfling for instance. You can use files, small ones of course, because they have to fit, like this one, and like this one, also round ones, like this one. Or you can use these kind of knives, but then you have to sharpen them on your own. Here you can change the blades. I will use this knife to start and then I will finish them with the files. The F-holes are starting to take shape, but as the top is still very thick, it's not so easy to work, especially in the small details. That's why I'm going to finish the thickness at the inner side, and then I will finish the F-holes. Now the top is approximately 5 mm, maybe 5.5, and I will make it eventually about 3-3.5 mm, so almost half is going away. I'm going to do this off camera, as there will be another video soon about the thickness. In the last video, I asked if you would like to send me some pictures of what you are doing, your instrument or your workspace. Several of you sent me pictures. I've put all of them on Facebook, the link is in the description if you would like to have a look. And now we will put some music on and we can have a look to the pictures. You can keep sending me photos. I will put them on Facebook and one of each I will put in the upcoming videos of the violin making series. In the meantime, I finished the inner part. Now the top is much thinner and I can proceed and finish the F-holes. I will still work a bit with a knife and then finish them up with the files. Ha 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 ha! after a lot of filing and cutting and sewing, the F-holes are finally done. And that means that in the next video we can place the base bar at the inner part of the top. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss the upcoming videos. Like this one if you liked it, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!